but here's what I want to talk about with you today on the integration marketplace. First off, I really want to start from zero and discuss the question, why integrations are even important for Personio? Why are we spending time and effort on this topic, right? And then looking into the Personio marketplace, which Hannah already mentioned in the intro. Then later on, we will take a look at some of the tools that integrate with Personio, so the integration partners that we have on the marketplace. And then last but not least, we will take a look at the Personio public API and the question how you can, if you want to do so, build your own integrations with Personio and automate some of your processes. But to kick things off, as I mentioned, I want to start from zero and the question, why does Personio even care about integrations? And I think it's a valid and interesting question to ask because we sort of pride ourselves at being this sort of solution that covers the full employee lifecycle, right? So you could also question that and sort of ask, why are we not building everything ourselves, right? And sort of bundle everything in the Personio product. And in order to sort of explain this, I have another small analogy today. So I'm sure many of you have something like this in your pockets, right? When you get an iPhone or any smartphone that is, it already comes pre-packaged with a bunch of functionality, right? So sticking to the iPhone example, it comes with camera, weather, maps, all that kind of stuff. And I think it's, you know, apps that are really valuable and that I use every day. But then when I look at my own sort of home screen, there's a bunch of other stuff on there as well, right? Because the iPhone out of the box, it doesn't cover all of my needs. Like for me specifically, I need something to track my sort of sports activities when I go running or something. That's something I want to track. Then what about social media or managing messaging and maybe following specific newspapers that I might be interested in, right? This is something that doesn't come out of the box. And I'm sure for each of your phones, they might look different than my one, right? Because everyone has different requirements, different needs, different interests. So, and here's the thing, Apple, they're like a huge company, right? There are thousands of engineers, but even then, they cannot anticipate all of these specific needs and requirements of their millions of users out there. And you all know how Apple is solving the issue, right? That is the App Store. So with the App Store, Apple is really enabling third-party developers to build apps on top of their operating system. And you can then pick and choose specific apps depending on the specific requirements that you have. And then sort of you get this bundle of this hardware device, the software that comes sort of prepackaged out of the box, and some of the custom apps that are specifically relevant for you, and then sort of the whole package is what really is valuable for you. You might know where sort of this line of thought is going to. With Personio, we're kind of following a similar approach, right? Because as you all know, we do offer basic functionality along the whole employee lifecycle, right? So from applicant sourcing and tracking, onboarding, then managing employee data, absences, time tracking, then performance and offboarding, right? So we do have the whole thing. But similar to how everyone's phone home screen looks different, all of you out there, you have different requirements in your organizations as well, right? Like you might work in different industries and in different countries, different sizes, different cultures, and so on. And we're sort of facing the similar challenge, right? Like even with all the engineers that we have available, we cannot tailor all the solutions that we have to your specific and unique requirements. So this is really then where our integration ecosystem comes in, right? Because together with the all-in-one solution that Personio offers, which is sort of covering core functionalities that every one of you probably needs, on top, you can pick and choose specific integrations. One, to supplement Personio with functionality that we don't offer ourselves yet. For example, shift planning. Or you can also pick a best of breed tool in an area that is specific, especially important for you, right? For example, in performance development or applicant tracking. So then sort of zooming out, similar to how the iPhone works together with the App Store and third-party apps. Personio, the platform together with integrations, truly becomes this holistic HR platform. And, you know, I think if you sort of get the iPhone analogy, this is pretty straightforward. But besides that, besides extending and supplementing Personio core functionality integration, there's another reason why I think this is super critical. The thing is, we are living in a best of breed world. And recently, the number of specialized SaaS tools is really exploding. There's like startups popping out everywhere that are focusing on a very small part of the employee lifecycle, or either in other areas as well. And then depending on which study you look at, organizations out there use somewhere between 40 to 200 different apps. And as you might imagine, this leads to a couple of challenges that probably many of you face as well. So with regard to people data, people processes usually span across multiple different tools, right? So for example, looking at onboarding, you might create an employee profile in Personio, but then throughout the onboarding process, a couple of things need to happen in different departments, right? For example, in IT, they usually use different tools, for example, for managing user accounts, different tools, single sign-on, and these types of things, right? And this is usually happening somewhere else, and then they also have their own data, right? So the second challenge is the data then might live in different tools, different silos. But think about how many tools you use actually have some kind of representation of your employee list and organizational setups. I think many, many tools out there sort of need to know which employees work at your company, if they're active or inactive, which role they have, which department they work in. And then if you have multiple different tools that are not speaking to each other, it's actually a manual effort of keeping them in sync. And that's really the third challenge. The manual copy and pasting that is then required to keep all these different tools in sync. And, you know, this is one super annoying and boring, right? This is not the reason why you got an HR in the first place. But it's also error prone, right? Because it's a manual process and you have to switch between multiple different tools and tabs. So how can Personio really make a difference here? For most of our customers, probably for you as well, Personio really is the system of record for employee data, right? And the source of truth when it comes to employee data. And that, as I mentioned, is data that is required by many tools that are used across the organization, maybe even also in other departments. And with integrations, really what we're doing is we are automating this data transfer between Personio and different tools. So you can spend less time with tedious copy and pasting and more time on things that truly make a difference. So this is sort of why integration is important for us at Personio and why I'm also excited about it, because really it is extending the functionality and the reach of the Personio product while also automating some of the most tedious, annoying jobs that you could have. So that's sort of on the initial question, why are we even working on integrations? But now let's take a look at the Personio marketplace. As Hannah mentioned, your one-stop shop for all your HR integrations. So if we continue with the iPhone analogy, the Personio marketplace is to Personio essentially what the App Store is to Apple, right? So in a nutshell, it's a directory of all the integrations that we have with Personio. So you can similar to sort of a App Store-like experience. You can search through the integrations that we have. You can filter by category, sort of just see if there's a specific tool that you already use you might want to set up the integration with, or maybe you are looking for a specific tool, for example, in the area of travel expenses, and then before choosing one, you might want to check if it actually has an integration with Personio already, so you can make sure that later on you won't have to keep both systems in sync manually. For each integration, when you click on them, you get a sort of small profile page that has detailed information how the integration works, a couple of screenshots, and also quick links. And then for the integrations that we've built in-house at Personio, we're actually able to go through the whole activation and configuration process right inside the marketplace. So let's zoom in on some of the functionality I mentioned. So when you click on the integration, you sort of have this draw this profile patch slide in from the right hand side. And it essentially just tells you, you know, what the app in general does, sort of apart from the integration. So in this case, what is Slack, in case you're not familiar with that one. And then it explains how the integration specifically with Personio works, what data is transferred between the tools. And also we have a section on setting up the integration, sort of a guideline how that works. And then that's kind of cut off on the right side of the screenshot, but we have like a sidebar that has quick links to support, help center, and also a sales contact in case you're not already using the tool, but might want to jump on a demo call or get a trial account. As I mentioned, four integrations that we've built ourselves in Personio, the activation process also happens straight inside Personio. So on the integration profile page, there's a connect button that you can just click, and this triggers this config wizard that you see on the screenshot here. So it's rather simple. It's a step-by-step explanation of what you need to do to activate an integration. Because somewhere in this process, you need to say, yes, Slack has the permission to access my employee data, right? You need to authorize a third party to actually access specific parts of your Personio data. And then there's also usually a step involved where you need to map data between Personio and integration. For example, when you have custom attributes in Personio and custom attributes in another tool, you can sort of map both and sort of plug those together, make sure the data is correctly transferred. And then lastly, with some integrations, there are some specific configuration required. For example, with the Slack one, you can choose at which time the update is being sent. You can select the content and which channels it's sent to. So that's kind of depending on the type of integration, the type of feature that we have here. Now, one thing you might be wondering, how can I even access the marketplace? And the thing is, actually, we have two marketplaces, right? So one of them is living inside your Personio account. So if you are an admin or you have a role with the access right for the marketplace, you can just go to the settings into the marketplace. So that's sort of the option on the left-hand side. And then you can browse the integration, open the profile page, check out the detailed information, and also trigger the activation, right? So the config wizard that I've just shown you, that's happening inside your Personio app because that's tied, obviously, to your Personio account. But then also maybe if you're not yet a Personio customer or you don't have the required access right, there's a second, more publicly available version of the marketplace as well. So you can just navigate to marketplace.personio.de in your browser, and that gives you the public version of the marketplace. So you essentially have the same content, the same integrations, the same descriptions and images, and you also have the profile pages. The only thing that you will be missing here is the activation, because as I mentioned, this really needs to happen in your Personio account, because it's also tied to your specific Personio. So maybe we can just take a look at how it actually looks like. So when you navigate to the settings, you have this marketplace down here. And you know, I think it doesn't need a whole lot of explanations, pretty straightforward. You can filter the integrations by category. So if you're interested in something specific, you can just filter it. You have a search bar on here if you're looking for a specific tool. Then clicking on one of the integrations opens the detail drawer where you have some of the information, how it works. In this case, Slack in my test account, it's already being set up. So in case you want to make changes to the current setup, you can just jump into the settings. Then you can skip the first steps because it's already done. And now, for example, in this case, if I want to make changes to the setup here, I can easily do that and then update the integration. And then that's essentially it. And then if you open an integration that you haven't activated yet, I mentioned there's this connect button. If you click that, that triggers the process from the start. And then you just follow the steps that are described here. need to usually authenticate the other tool. Sometimes it's about inserting API keys. Sometimes you get this all of OAuth page that some of you may know, but then you can sort of manage it in here. And then if you go to marketplace.personio.de, that's the publicly facing marketplace. So similar story, we have categories and collections here as well. You can just browse through it, search for integrations, and you know, we have these profile pages as well. So yeah, if you haven't seen that already after this presentation, definitely check that out. So coming back to the presentation. That was the Personio Marketplace, right? I think it should be pretty straightforward. It's sort of where you will find out everything about integration with Personio. You can activate the ones that are built by Personio. But what you probably are more interested in is sort of not the app store, but the actual apps that are available, right? So let's take a look at the Personio integration ecosystem and which tools we currently integrate with. So starting off on a high level, which integrations do we have today? We have more than 50, so I will not go through all of them. I think that would be rather boring. You can browse the marketplace later on. But we do have integration on all sorts of different areas. So we have 13 categories at the moment. We are continuing to add more. But from very early in the process to like applicant sourcing and assessment to, you know, identity and access, payroll, performance, we are already covering a broad range, but we are continuing to add more. For example, learning and management systems is something that we will add rather soon. Benefits is definitely more things on the horizon. So when I joined Personio a little over a year ago, I think we had less than 20 integrations, and most of them were really dark focused. So probably most of them you wouldn't know unless you're sort of located in Germany yourself. So what I think is really exciting, that one, our integration system is growing super fast at the moment. So it's essentially doubling every year. So we're above 50 already and have 20 integrations in development at the moment that will be released rather soon. And what's also interesting is that most of these aren't really specific to Germany or the German-speaking region, right? So about half of the new integrations that are being released at the moment are specific to countries outside of Germany. So many are relevant for UK, Nordics, Spain, Benelux. So I'm sure some of you out there, some of the integrations that are coming up might be interesting for you as well. So as I mentioned, feel free to jump into the marketplace, explore some of them yourself. But two of them I do want to call out and sort of zoom in on is the Slack integration and the Greenhouse one, because those were released together with the marketplace back in April as well and built by our team. With Slack, it's rather interesting because I think back then it was by far the most requested Personio integration. So I was really excited when we were finally able to get that released. At the moment, there's two core functionalities with the Personio Slack app. The first one is you can get a notification every morning into a channel of your choice that includes today's absences, birthdays, anniversaries, and new joiners. The thing is that this message can be sent to multiple channels and filtered by department, ops, and team. So what this essentially means is you can create a mapping between a organizational unit in Personio and a specific Slack channel. So for example, you can choose to send this message into the marketing channel and only consider employees that are in the department marketing, or on a team level, this works similarly. And this is really to make sure that the message really contains information that is relevant for that specific subgroup, right? So for example, in our integrations team, we have set it up in a way that the message that we get every morning only includes employees that are actually in our team. And then it's actually pretty cool. We use it at Personio as well, obviously, with Slack. And you know, when then someone's birthday arrives and you get the notification by Slack, usually people jump into the Slack thread, you know, congratulate that person with sharing gifts or something. So that's pretty cool to see. Same with company anniversaries or greeting new joiners. So that's pretty neat. That's the first functionality of the Slack app. And then the second one is about automatically updating the Slack status. So based on the absences in Personio, we are changing employee status, including the absence type and the return date. So let's say you're waking up not feeling great, then you can just pull out your phone with the Personio mobile app, request a sick day. And then once this is requested, Personio will automatically change your Slack status update, and then your colleagues will see that you're not feeling great and that you're out today. So that's one less thing that you have to worry about, because when you're not feeling great, the last thing you want to do is pull out your laptop and sort of letting people know you're not able to work that day. So we know not everyone might want to share sort of the absence type as well. So that's why in the configuration process, you can either choose to make that status message generic. So then it will say something like absent and then back on the date, right? So it will not say that you're on vacation or out sick. Or you can also include the status as you see on the screenshot here. And then you will sort of have a emoji, which is indicating the absence type. And then if you, on Hover, you will have this tooltip that indicates when you're back. So in Greenhouse, that's another integration we built. It's fairly straightforward as well. When you use Greenhouse for applicant tracking and you hire someone, we are automatically creating a new employee in Personio. So again, we are automating this manual process of creating a new employee profile and then copy and paste the attributes. What's pretty interesting about this one is that in the configuration wizard, you can do essentially a one-by-one mapping between Greenhouse and Personio. So on the left-hand side, you will have the attributes in Greenhouse, on the right-hand side, the ones in Personio. And then you can map custom and system attributes between both systems to make sure that you're really transferring the full profile and not, you know, only first name, last name, and having to manually transfer the rest. All right. So that was the integrations that we saw today. As I mentioned, didn't go through 50 integrations. So definitely encourage you to check out some of them that we have directly on the marketplace. Now for the last topic, I want to cover custom integration and the Personio public API. I mentioned we are continuing to add more and more integrations, right? And really the ecosystem around Personio is growing rapidly. But you've also seen the study that I shared earlier, right? There's companies out there using 200 different tools. So the math is pretty simple, right? There might still be cases where we are not integrating with tools that you're using, right? Maybe something a bit more exotic, something not used by many customers, or something we'll be adding later. And so one option is definitely reaching out to us, letting us know that this is something you're interested in, and then we'll see how we can make it happen. And the other option that you have is building a custom integration using the Personio public API. So in case you either have developer capacity in-house or you're working with a third-party developer, this is also something that you can look into. So I'm sure not everyone in the audience is super technical, right? So let's quickly talk about on a high level what an API even is. Generally, there's sort of two ways how people or also not people can interact with Personio, right? So you and me, how we usually use Personio is using the graphical user interface. That's just a fancy word for saying you're sitting in front of your computer or the mobile app, you're using your mouse and your keyboard to do certain tasks in Personio, right? Like creating employees, updating employees, checking time, all that stuff. Now that's sort of you, a human, interacting with software, right? But if you think about integrations, obviously the integration is not sitting in front of a computer and moving the mouse around. That's essentially what APIs are for. So API is the application programming interface, and that's sort of the interface that software is using to interact with other software. So in this example, Peakon, for example, can access your employee data using the public API. And of course, there's also sort of the security step in between that Peakon needs to prove that you have authorized them to access specific parts of your employee profile. Now, Personio offers one of these public APIs. If you're interested to learn more about how that works, you can go to our developer hub. I think it's on the developer.personio.com. And that's sort of where we have all the documentation, how that works, how you can get started. On a high level, there's four segments of that API, so four different functionalities, similar to what we have in the Personio product as well. So we have the employee API, where, as the name suggests, you can fetch employee data, such as email names, roles, which is pretty interesting. If you really want to make Personio your source of truth and only keep that up to date, and then when something has changed, pull that from a different tool as well to make sure it's in sync. So we have an attendance API that you can use to read, write, and update attendance data. Same for absences. Here you can also get absence types and balances, but then obviously also creating absence periods and updating existing ones. Lastly, with recruiting, maybe some of you might have custom career pages, then you're probably using the XML feed, which you can use to export open job postings. And lastly, on the recruiting API, you can also push new applications into Personio. For example, when you have a custom application form somewhere on your website. So that's the functionality of the Personio public API. As I mentioned, if you're interested, if you have some basic experience with APIs, or you know someone in your company that knows how that works, and you have an idea how you could automate a process, your best bet would be just to go to Developer Hub. If you click that Get Started button on the page, we have a couple of guidelines on there and sort of step-by-step walking you through how you can actually go about getting started with your first custom integration. So we are getting to the end of today's presentations. That's all I wanted to cover. Before we go to the last section on questions, I do want to call out that I also need your help. As I mentioned, we are adding more and more integrations, but we definitely want to make sure that the ones that we add are valuable for you out there, right? So in case there's tools that you use on a day-to-day basis, but you think it would be cool if some data would be transferred from Personio to that tool or vice versa, definitely reach out to us and let us know that you are interested. You can, as Daniele mentioned, you can go to the Personio community, use the ideation section on there, or after this presentation, if you go to the public marketplace, we also have a request integration button on the left-hand sidebar. We can just fill out the form, let us know which tool you'd like to see. And then we'll see how we can make that happen, either by reaching out to that company, seeing if we can partner up, or building it ourselves. The second bit I wanted to call out was our beta testing program. So usually when you're building a new integration, there's a testing period involved as well. So we really make sure that, you know, we hit that quality bar, it works as expected. So if you're interested in testing new integrations before everyone else, I definitely encourage you to join our beta testing program as well. You can just go to the Personio website, and then when you sign up for the customer newsletter, there's just a small checkbox that you have to tick if you want to join the beta customer pool. So yeah, really, that's everything I wanted to cover. And I guess we have a couple of more minutes for questions in case we have any.
Cool. Thanks for your prezi, Matthias. We do have a couple of questions from the chat. The most voted one so far is from Hien. Do all partners of Personio in the marketplace comply with GDPR?
Yes, so definitely. We do have a pretty robust partnership program. So it's not like you can just randomly build an integration and then we're sort of welcoming you with open arms and putting your logo on the website, right? It's actually a pretty long process where when they reach out, we sort of check their product, right? Then they start building integration, and then we have sort of a quality assessment of that tool and the integration as well. So this is something that we check as well throughout the whole partnership process. And this is also something that we are improving at the moment. Sort of in the earlier days, it was more lightweight, this whole partnership process, but now we're actually introducing contractual agreements as well with our partners to make sure if you want to be listed on the marketplace, there's certain things you need to abide to.
Cool. Yeah, makes total sense. Then we have two questions about the Slack integration. One of them is Nadine. Are these automated messages in Slack editable?
I guess editable, referring to the content of that message, or if a user can edit it respectively. I think probably the first one, right? So there's certain things that you can customize in the setup. So you can choose at which time the message is being sent, as I mentioned, in which channel it's being sent to. And you can also customize the content of that message. So in case you only want absences, essentially you have 4 checkboxes in the setup. And then if you only want absences, just tick that one. If you only want birthdays, tick that one. Or if you want everything, you can have that as well. So cool. That's sort of what you can sort of edit at the moment with the message.
Cool. Thank you so much. And then we have another question about Slack. Are there any Slack updates foreseen? Basically, there is a person that when they have a to-do on their dashboard or when someone made some sort of action in the recruitment part to get a Slack notification regarding the recruiting section. Is there anything planned there?
Yeah, definitely. So one thing I can share is that we are currently still working on the Slack app, right? So it's not like we built the first iteration and we're not touching it again. Matter of fact, this is something the team is currently working on, right? So I'm not yet allowed to share too many details, but I can say sort of a couple of broader topics that we're looking into is that you will be able to trigger actions inside Slack that will then sort of trigger workflows in Persona, right? So task management is something that we are at some point going to look into, but also absences, sort of this broader topic. So definitely stay tuned. And we have a couple of exciting updates coming, probably scheduled around early Q4.
Cool. Awesome. And then another question is, it would also be helpful to adjust the way absences are shown in Outlook via the calendar integration. Is there anything planned here that you know of?
Right. So I don't think we have plans at the moment for the calendar integrations, right? So not specifically for Q3. But that being said, it sounds like the person that asked the questions has some ideas how we could improve it. So similar to what we previously said, definitely let us know in the ideation section, and then that's something we can look into.
Cool. Sounds good.